Really good AI-generated videos are here. A couple days ago, OpenAI rolled out some demos of their new text-to-video tool, which they're calling Sora. And essentially, you feed Sora a prompt in plain English, and it creates a video based on what you asked it. So here on the screen is the webpage for Sora, and you can see these paper airplanes flying through a forest like birds. So that was created from a text prompt. And then if you scroll down, they have something like 30 other examples on the site here. And the first one is a woman walking through a brightly lit street at night. And here is the prompt. These are the exact prompts that they used to create these videos. So it says, a stylish woman walks down a Tokyo street filled with a warm, glowing neon and animated city signage. She wears a black leather jacket, yada, yada, yada. I won't read the whole thing. But as you can see, if you didn't know this was AI, you could be convinced that it's real. The light reflecting off of the puddles, the people in the background, it's really, really good. It's not perfect. If you look close, you'll find imperfections. There's some weird movement to the people, their feet turn in strange angles and things like that. But the reason that I'm making this video is look at what AI was making 9 months ago. I'm gonna switch over to YouTube. Here's something called AI-generated video with dogs. And this is from May 2023. And like weird stuff is happening. The dog is getting bigger. This dog's head is coming out of the car. He disappears into the car. This guy turns into a dog, but is that even a dog? It looks like a deer. So 9 months ago. Now, if I switch over to this is another Sora-generated video with dogs. So look what happens now. Look, you can see the shadows. The dogs stay together. They're not getting bigger. They're not doing any sort of weird stuff. And the fur is bouncing as it runs, and the tail's swishing around. Just super realistic. Like you could convince me that that's a real video that you took with your iPhone. And now consider this one. This one again is an old one. This is from 8 months ago, and this is on YouTube. So let me go ahead and play it. And as you can see, it's a mess. This guy has multiple mouths. The sauce bottle is missing. It's super weird and kind of scary, right? Well, here's what humans look like from Sora. So I'll go ahead and play this one. Super realistic, right? That could be filmed once again with your iPhone. Like you could tell me this is a video off of some family's recording. And some weird stuff happened. Like at the end, she tries to blow on the candle and it doesn't go out. And the AI still distorts things. The physics aren't quite right. If you notice the candles, some of them are blowing in different directions. One of them has flames going in two different directions. But if this is the progress made in less than 1 year, imagine what we'll have 1 year from today. We're about to see an explosion of creativity when these types of tools get into the hands of everyone. Sora and tools like it will probably be built into your video editing software. And whenever you need stock footage, you can simply prompt it to add whatever it is that complements what you're speaking about. Your B-roll will just be generated on the fly. And within 3 years, I predict we'll see full-length movies created entirely by AI tools like Sora. And I don't mean weird, bad ones. I mean good ones that compete with Hollywood and Netflix, ones made with completely AI-generated actors. And within 7 to 10 years, there will be a service like Netflix where it asks you, what do you want to watch? And you'll be able to prompt it just again through plain English. Give me my favorite actor, or even use me as the actor starring in a, I don't know, zombie movie or whatever your favorite genre is, set in New York or whatever rural town that you're living in. And it will generate that movie for you on the fly. Eventually, it might even use something like a fitness tracker, like some sort of biometrics to measure your heart rate and your other biometric signals to see how much you're actually enjoying that movie and adjust it according to your specific taste, or how you enjoyed movies in the past. It might adjust the ending to your specific taste, and then you and all of your friends get a different ending. So that's where I think this is all heading, is hyper-personalized entertainment. Just like creator-made content has led to a massive exodus away from the studio-produced content, I think this technology, AI-generated video, will further that. If you wanted to create a full-length film, but you have no cameras, no budget, no actors, no experience, it won't matter. Through a series of prompts in English, You will be able to create anything you want. A kid in his mom's basement will create better movies than Hollywood can through traditional means. Now, of course, there's going to be a ton of garbage produced, especially at first, but out of billions and billions of creations, some incredible art is going to emerge. But remember, this is like version 0.01 of this technology. Today, February 17th, as I record this, is the worst that this tech will ever be. Things are about to get interesting.